Over the last few years, a new generation is getting to learn about the 1990 Chicago Bulls dynasty. You can thank The Last Dance in 2020 for helping to re-kick some of that energy. But for those here in Chicago that lived through it, those memories are always top of mind, including a Chicago historian who certainly remembers the impact that the most famous player on that team had on Chicago and the world. Sherman Dilla Thomas, this latest lesson starts with a personal connection. Well, more of a reward for a job well done. He's had for a number of years.
When Chicago Bulls invite me to come speak to their players, when the Chicago White Sox invite me to take their ace kids out on a neighborhood tour, when the check comes, I reinvested into my business all but whatever it costs to get one pair of shoes, and those shoes are Michael Jordan shoes. It's my way of being able to physically look down and see how far I've come.
With a pair of Air Jordan sneakers. And that's where the lesson of the impact of the 1990s Bulls, along with Michael Jordan, begins for this historian.
A lot of tourists would come to Chicago.
Who spoke about it during a lecture at the Harold Washington Library on October 30.
Days into
the Chicago Public Library and the Public Library Foundation has been doing events all this year. So it's 2023 and they've been calling it the Year of Jordan. And so we collaborated to have that event.
And to kick off that lesson, Thomas started with the kicks that in many ways kick-started a few people's careers.
It certainly has created its own economy. There are several boutique stores. Bobby Simmons has a store, Success. Don C, who's very famous Chicago ambassador and fashion designer, he has a store, RSVP. And a lot of those things, their main focus is selling Michael Jordan shoes. And so that's an economy, right? That allows for them to provide for their families. That allows for them to pay employed people who also are able to pay their bills solely off of his shoes. And then the resale market, right? There's this thing that, you know, a lot of people that are sneakerheads like me call StockX. And it's basically the stock market for gym shoes, right? And, you know, by and large, the number one seller on any of those shoes, on that site, rather, is the Michael Jordan shoes.
Those grew as the Jordan-led Bulls captured 6 NBA championships in the 1990s, captivating a city and country in one of the greatest team sports runs of all time. While it changed a lot of footwear for people, it also changed the footprint of Chicago.
Just look at the West Loop, right? How can you describe that economic impact and vitality in that area in just an hour? That's really hard, too. And a lot of that comes from Harpo Studios and from Michael Jordan winning 6 rings with the Chicago Bulls. You know, we formerly used to call that place Skid Row, the stretch of Madison from Wells to, say, about Western. That was full of SROs or single-room occupants. It was a place that, you know, a lot of Chicagoans wouldn't want their kids to be traveling alone. And then today it's like one of the most swankiest spots in the city.
Though it's not all about money when it comes to Jordan. Thomas wants people here to know.
Just how philanthropic Mike Jordan was when he's here. You know, there's a narrative that, particularly right when he after he won and all the stuff with Craig Hodges, and, you know, he wasn't the most political person in Chicago, but a number of things such as the alternative school networks, a lot of that was funded by Michael Jordan and the Juanita Jordan Foundation. And, you know, routinely kids would be able, whole basketball teams had their programs funded by his shoes and by Nike, and all of that was because he was the liaison for it.
That's what I understand.
It's a lot of Bulls basketball history that he had to teach quickly.
It was amazingly difficult to try to pack it all in a 1 hour program.
Hotels.
But the students could absorb it, not only through Dilla's words, but also his wardrobe.
I've never been seen publicly without a pair of Jordans on in my life, right? Well, at least since I've started this historian journey.
You can see more on Thomas's lecture on the Chicago Bulls of the 1990s and their impact on Chicago and the country in the story below or WGNTV.com. Larry Hawley, WGN News Now.